The main thing we do is embolize bleeding lesions. So that's our core business, but it involves much more. It also involves interpreting the imaging, so the initial imaging, because selecting patients is probably as important as doing the procedure itself. So it's a combination of understanding the patient needs, understanding to the imaging, interpreting the imaging, having a good set of criteria for which patients to do and which patients not to do. The most exciting things are, one, treatment of aortic rupture, traumatic aortic rupture, because basically surgical treatment has been replaced by stent graft placement completely over the past few years. And so that's been a major shift in treatment and also a major improvement in treatment. If you look at new treatment and workup algorithms for trauma, the IR has a much more fixed place in the algorithms now. We recently made a guideline with CIRSE, and that features a very central role for IR in the treatment algorithms. So the technique itself hasn't changed considerably over the past few years. It's more that the use of the technique and where to use it has become much more fixed, thereby expanding the number of patients that we are treating. Still not everyone is completely known with all the possibilities we have for treating aortic rupture or bleeding of all different types of organs, not only livers and spleens, but also the pelvis, mesenteric vessels, supra-aortic branches going to the neck and the head, extremity trauma. I guess not many people are aware of all the things that we can do, so we should be there to offer our service and show them what we can do. So that's why IR should be involved from the start. So, what we're seeing in our practice is that when a patient comes into this trauma bay, a clinically unstable patient or a patient under suspicion of serious trauma, IR gets called in right away. So what happens usually is we go down to the trauma bay. We're actually there when the trauma patient comes in and when the imaging occurs. We do have direct access to CT scanning in the trauma bay so that we get the imaging right away. We see if there's a bleed or a false aneurysm or a cut off artery or anything of that kind. We consult with the trauma surgeon straight away, discuss the hemodynamic situation, the amount of time we would need to do the procedure, the indication for the procedure, and then we either do or do not do the case. So this happens on a direct discussion basis in the presence of the patient in the trauma bay. That's the way to do it. And this probably should happen in every level one trauma center. Of course, if you're going to do this, you have to have IRs who are always present and who are always available to consult 24/7. Very important. If you realize that two-thirds of trauma patients, or even maybe more than two-thirds of trauma cases, will be out of office hours, it becomes self-evident that you have to have the service 24/7.